When did Philippine-China trade begin? Philippine maritime history goes all the way to the Stone Age, over 4,000 years ago, when our Austronesian ancestors imported jade from Taiwan, crafted them into ling-ling os and bicephalous jade ornaments, exported them to Thailand, Vietnam, Burma, Cambodia, Hong Kong, and Malaysia. So far, more than 400 green nephrite ornaments have been discovered in the Philippines at about 20 different sites. Abundant jade artifacts in a country with no known indigenous source of jade tells of our Philippine ancestors' amazing sea-going vessels thousands of years ago. Another clue to ancient international trade, ling-ling o and bicephalous forms, contemporaneous to their jade counterparts, had been carved out of what appears to be a natural form of impact glass. The video, Philippine Central Asiatic Stone Age Trade, shares ancient texts that identifies a West Asiatic source for the imported material. In Philippine-Japan relations, how far back does it go? Terracotta artifacts were discussed that may push Philippine-Japan relations to the start of the first millennium BC. The beads they valued most may have identified mysterious beads described in the Boxer Codex that could have been used as a form of international currency by the maritime merchant Phoenicians and the Kingdom of Israel. Artifacts of core-formed fused glass faces found in the Philippines and worn by tribes are shown in Cartage Was Here, exploring the possibility of contact and trade with that ancient North African civilization. If You Were a Celt in Batanes presents current archaeological discoveries that may imply Celtic tribes from Europe settled in the Philippines during the Bronze Age. Prehistoric Philippines was a very busy international trading center with merchants coming from our neighboring Southeast Asian countries, Africa, and Europe. How about China? How far back has Philippines traded with China? It is to the Neolithic Hongshan culture that archaeologists and scholars have traced the roots of ancient China. Archaeological studies show that Hongshan culture was developed on the basis of Xinglonghua and Zhaobaogao cultures. A study of these cultures is of great significance to the exploration of the origin of the Chinese civilization. The Neolithic Hongshan culture of northern China has yielded large quantities of nephrite jade artifacts with more than 52 different types in various shapes and forms. Typical Hongshan jade items are pig dragons, embryo dragons, and cirrus-shaped jade articles. Among all Hongshan culture jade forms, one stands out. In particular, one the archaeologists label pig dragon appears singularly important. Found primarily in burial context, laid on the chest of the male ruling elite, the Julong is a coiled mythical animal with oval eyes, pig snout, and rounded ears. It most certainly is one of the ancestors of the Chinese dragon, it being representative of the Hongshan jade culture, the prime image of the Chinese dragon. This ancestral jade dragon may have been worn by the Hongshan ruler in life and accompanied him in death. The common appearance of this fabled power symbol amidst Hongshan jades and ritual imagery of other later succeeding Longshan cultures strongly suggests a northeastern origin that impacted the center of the East Asian heartland region that evolved into what we identify as modern-day China. The prototype of the dragon is the thick jade coil shape, defined at one end by a prominent head, crowned by a pair of large ear flaps, and by a large central perforated hole on Hongshan jades. More frequently than not, head and tail remain connected by a narrow slice of jade left behind the figure's snout. The tail and body are typically left undifferentiated. A small hole for suspension is punctured behind the ear flaps of the dragon. The ear flaps and head are the most detailed part of this fabled creature. The most exquisitely rendered versions define a head with large rising ovoid-shaped ear flaps encompassing small circular eye sockets above tear-shaped nostrils and a jaw with opposing upward and downward pointing tusks. Because the attributes are suggestive of the wild boar and the body suggestive of the dragon, the image has been dubbed by archaeologists a pig dragon. In Five Things, Liangzhou Culture in the Philippines, we trace the journey of our Austronesian-speaking ancestors to what Chinese scholars call the Liangzhou Culture from the lower Yangtze River area, a jade working culture that mysteriously disappeared around 2500 BC. Around the same time, a fully formed jade culture appeared on the Philippine Islands. Neolithic Hongshan and Liangzhou cultures traded with each other, sharing forms like the bai disc and some jade working technologies. The artisans of Liangzhou developed their skills from the overlapping culture of the Hongshan, but expanded the variety of subjects to provide people with more choices. Could the Neolithic Hongshan culture, the origins of the Chinese nation, have continued to trade with the Austronesians, the Liangzhou culture, even after they had moved to their new location? Interestingly, the Liangzhou culture centered in south coastal China in Zhejiang and Jiangsu provinces of today never produced a dragon in any artistic form. Nephrite jade pig dragons found in the Philippines have long been used as anting-anting, a protective talisman. Similar to scholars' conjectures, the mythical form of the image implicates that the jade was a symbol endowing one who wore and or displayed it with mythical power. Two large pig dragons were found by construction workers who were excavating to build a fountain in front of Santa Cruz Church in Escolta. The remains in the ancient graves were given to the church, and the pig dragons were sold to collectors. A very special kind of metal diffusion is found on authentic Hongshan jade. On many Hongshan jade pieces, very often, such sparkling metal spots or metal streaks can be found. This is especially true on some very black-skinned jades. They believe these metal spots, gold glitter, are oxidized iron formed on the jades. High iron content in the black nephrite jade give the artifacts a strong magnetic force, able to hold a magnet in place. Many Hongshan culture-type artifacts have been found in the Philippines. But it is the unmistakable Julong pig dragon that links China and the Philippines as ancient trading partners from Neolithic times. Who was ancient Philippines? Why were so many nations trading with our amazing ancestors? Watch Five Things Every Filipino Should Know About History. Because a generation which ignores history has no past and no future. Thank you for joining us in opening the book of our past in the hopes of a brighter future.